And you were here at the NGC that we had last Friday, where the lineup for our neck was set up. This morning, we've had a meeting as an office to streamline issues and to discuss, because we've said ODM is the force of any party that there ever is going to be in Kenya. And we've set the ball rolling. We've had discussions from about 9 a.m. and we're going to continue to have all these more discussions. These are very, very critical to the party. I am the Deputy Secretary General of the party in charge of administration. We have the Deputy Secretary General in charge of political affairs. And on my right is the Secretary General of ODM.
Thank you.
We are confident about his leadership. We are looking forward from the meeting we've had this morning. We've already really set up a very constructive path of how we're going to move on as a party. So I want to welcome our SG.
Thank you. Welcome the Secretary General,
and then we can invite the Deputy Secretary General. And before I do that, I want to symbolically
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Mheshimiwa Agnes Zani, our very able outgoing SG, and she's now going to be in the same office with me as my assistant and helper and guide in this extremely challenging position that I've been given. First of all, I want to take this opportunity to thank the party leader and the National Executive Council and the NGC of the party for bestowing upon me this great honor of leading this juggernaut, that is ODM. As you all know, this is the biggest party in Eastern Central Africa. And I do understand that it is an onerous task, but with the support of my colleagues here, we are going to run this office as a unit. My two deputies are very able deputies, who I am sure will guide my every step to ensure that we succeed. What I want to tell members of ODM and the public in general is that we are upon a renaissance now. We want to revamp this party so that we reclaim the glory that ODM has always had. We want to encourage any one of us who might have felt disaffected to be a member or unhappy here, that we have set in place mechanisms and we have the spirit and the psyche to be able to accommodate all those people who may have felt otherwise disenfranchised in ODM. So we welcome back all members, and of course it is our responsibility to also grow the membership by attracting new members. What we want to make clear is that we want to restore the pride of the members of ODM. For a very long time, our members have been forced to stay silent when they should speak. They have been forced to stay put when they should move. They have been forced to whisper when they should shout, especially because there are people who feel insecure around such a big party, such as ODM. What we want to do is that from now onwards, ODM will stop apologizing for what it is. We will not apologize anymore for being the biggest party. We will not apologize anymore for being the most popular party. We will not apologize anymore for being the party with the largest number of elected officials in this country. So those of us who are our friends should be aware that even when you set on a journey and there's three of you, and one of you is tall and the rest or the others are not tall, you do not tell me to walk on my knees so that we can look the same height. What you do is you ask me to carry you so that we can all look tall. So we will no longer, as a party, be apologizing for who we are. And we want to say as an office, our motto is going to be ODM first, ODM Kwanza, because we have to look at ourselves first before we can be able to take care of our friends and other interests. We also want to take this opportunity to encourage our members that the fight ahead is a difficult fight. We know that we are faced with grievous challenges as a country. We have the responsibility of ensuring that electoral justice is finally actualized in this country. We have not moved on from the election of 2017. We are still seeking answers. Number two, we have an emerging dictatorship in the country which has to be fought by every ounce of strength in our bodies. And number three, we have to be defenders of the rule of law. When we talk about the rule of law, it is not a matter that affects ODM only. Rule of law, the observance of court orders, and the fact that people must be subjected to the law is a matter that affects all of us. Yesterday you heard in the news that the police shot and killed a student leader in Meru. That student leader was a Kenyan like all of us, who is entitled to due process of the law. Whatever crime he had committed, it was the responsibility of the police to apprehend and bring him before the law, and not to execute him in the streets like a common criminal. And as ODM, we have been saying this, that respect for the rule of law also includes subjecting everyone to the judicial process, to ensure there are no extrajudicial killings. We as a party have suffered the brunt of extrajudicial killings. Human Rights Watch has just put out a report that over 100 citizens in Nairobi alone were killed by the police following the election of August and October. So this is a matter that affects all Kenyans, and we want to encourage even our partners that because the harvest is plenty and the workers are few, we would rather concentrate on the fighting the dictatorship and on electoral justice than on squabbling internally. So for us as ODM, we are extremely focused. We want to ensure that we achieve electoral justice from the elections of August and October, and that we will put ODM first. With me here are my deputies, and out of the meeting we have resolved that we are going to revamp the branch network and leadership at the branches, that the exercise that has happened at the national level of filling all the vacancies that have been occasioned by defections and those who left the movement have to be refilled, and we will be soon communicating with the branch leadership, the leadership of the party in the counties, on that particular process. So I want to thank you. I want to thank all the staff who work at Orange House for welcoming us. I want to thank all my able deputies and everyone in ODM for giving me this opportunity to be your Secretary General. I will conclude by requesting my very able deputy, Madam Florence Mutua, the women rep for Busia, to also say something as we conclude. Thank you very much.
The protocol is that I should have spoken before the SG. He has said everything, actually. But I must, first and foremost, thank the party leader and the members of ODM for giving me the position for Deputy Secretary General. I'm very honored, and I'm ready to serve, and I'll continue giving it my best. We also must commend Honorable Zani for having acted and done her work diligently as the Acting Secretary General. She did good work. We commend her, because we have found the office, what she has handed over. She has really been doing a lot of work, so we must commend her, and we appreciate her, and we are happy to continue working with her as one of our Deputy Secretary Generals, because we also need her institutional memory in that office. We have talked a lot of things that the SG has talked about. I don't want to repeat them, but the two critical things, especially for me, because we have already been delegated duties, is the issue of ensuring that we restructure our party, because after every election, there are people that leave the party. So we are going to make sure we bring people back on board, and also to recruit more members, and also, most importantly, to revamp our party. Our party is the only biggest party in East and Central Africa, and we are very proud of that. So we will not, as well as the way SG has said, we will not apologize for being the biggest party. We will not apologize for being the most loved party. So us, as the three of us in the Secretary General's office, we are going to give it our best. And we can also be doing frequent meetings with the media to update them on what we are doing as a party. Thank you very much. And we also want to thank the staff, the secretariat. They have been very supportive. They always give it their best. We have our own Etale. Etale has really been doing very good work for us in the media. Without him, we wouldn't have been able to communicate all the issues that we do. And all the others who are in here in this secretariat, they have played their roles. We want to recognize one, the finance director, Kawino. Without him, we wouldn't have any money even to drink water, and you can see me with water here. So we want to continue working with the ED closely, because he has stood with what needs to be done here in the secretariat, and we want to thank him. And all the others, I can't name them all, but we want to thank all of you for any role that you play, whether it is voluntary or whether you are a staff. So that's all that I can say. We are really happy to have a youth energetic SG. That means our party wants to work with the youth. So we are very happy. He calls me Mama Flores, which I'm his mother. So we are going to hold his hand. We are going to guide him. He also has knowledge that maybe we don't have. So with this combined, I think we are going to propel the party to higher heights. Thank you very much.
Yeah, maybe for purposes of our colleagues from Royal Media, we like outgoing as it will do the symbolic handover. Say something.
Okay. Please. Is it your hand? Here or there?
Yeah.
Okay. Once again, asante sana.
Congratulations.
Sawa?
Good.
Do
you have it?
Okay. Anything else?
Any
question?
Yes.
For us who are late, probably a summary of
that. We have basically come to hand over the office of the SG from our outgoing SG. Acting SG, Madam Zani, and we started by thanking the party leader and the National Executive Council of the party and the National Governing Council for this great honor that has been bestowed upon me and the youth of ODM in general for us to lead this juggernaut of a party that is the biggest in Eastern Central Africa. We know that we have a lot of challenges lying ahead. We hope that with the revamping of the national office, those people who might have felt disenfranchised and left ODM will have the confidence to come back to the party, because this is the party that represents the aspirations and the dreams of Kenyans. We want to work hand in hand with all the party organs and the leadership of the party, the parliamentary group, and all the other organs, so that we revamp the party. We have just had a discussion this morning to agree that just like the party has taken steps to fill the vacancies at the national level, we will cascade this down to the branches and all the regions, so that all vacancies in those branch offices are filled in the shortest time possible, so that we can begin the work of revamping and revitalizing the party. We as ODM recognize that we are in extremely perilous times with the emerging dictatorship in this country. And it is our responsibility as a party to be at the forefront of fighting this emerging dictatorship. We know that we are on a quest for electoral justice. We will not discuss matters of 2022 until the matters of electoral justice to do with the election in 2017. Are done and concluded. We want to encourage every person to focus on the true enemy of the people, which is the Jubilee dictatorship. But we also want to warn those who might stand in the way of us dealing with the enemy, that if it is not in your genetic makeup to fight a dictatorship, then you need to allow those of us who have nothing else but to seek justice in this country to be able to pursue that cause. So we do not anticipate that any person will get in the way of the agenda of ODM, and we have made it clear that as a party we want to restore the pride of the members of ODM in the party, that we will no longer be forced to stay silent where we should shout, that we will no longer be forced to walk on our knees so that our shorter colleagues can feel better about themselves, that we will no longer be forced to stand still when we know we should run. So we are moving forward as a party. We want to assure the country that ODM will not give up the quest for electoral justice, that we will not give up the fight against the emerging dictatorship of Uhuru Kenyatta, that we will not give up the fight for the rule of law. And we made reference to the incident yesterday where a student leader in Meru was shot by police officers. When we talk about the rule of law, some of them might think that this is an issue that is peculiar to ODM or ODM members. An injustice anywhere is an injustice everywhere. So we know that when we talk about the respect of the rule of law, we as ODM have borne the brunt of police brutality and the extrajudicial killings. As you are aware, there was a report that was put out by Human Rights Watch just recently that over 100 people in this city alone were executed in cold blood by the police following the election. Nobody should have to die for exercising their rights to protest peacefully in this country. So we condemn very strongly the murder of a student leader in Embu and Meru. And we want to assure the country that we will not discriminate whether an injustice happens in our strongholds or anywhere else in this country, because every injustice occasioned to a Kenyan is an injustice to all of us. I believe that is as much as we have covered for those of you who have come here.
During the campaigns and even after, ODM has been calling for a referendum, sort of the reforms that we have been talking about, the rules of rights. Given what happened yesterday with the introduction of a new bill to introduce the position of a prime minister, what is your take on all that? Because people are thinking it's going to affect you as well.
Well, you do know that as a party, we have had a leaning towards the organization of the executive in the country. This is something that has been expressed even by the top leadership of the party, that indeed we need to look at the structure of the executive in this country. But we as a party, I am not aware of a position that has been taken with regards to that particular bill, so that it would be preemptive of me to speak on that particular bill. Which we are still studying. Our parliamentary group has to come and brief us on the contents of that bill, and then we will receive direction from the leadership of the party on the contents of that bill. But we do know that any amendments to the structure of the executive has to be done through a referendum of the people of Kenya.
Any other question? If there's none, thank you.
Thank you very much.
We'd like to inform you that tomorrow the SG will be in Kitale for a rally after the ruling on the petition of the supporting member. So there'll be a big rally in Kitale town.
Thank you. See you in Kitale.
So, Karibu.
Asante.